Okay, so I will be taking a food break soon, and thus we're going to be doing just a little bit more here. We can, how much wood do we have? We have 408, that should be good enough. So I'm going to continue playing this, get the house going a little bit more, and then we are going to stop playing for a little bit to get some foods in me tummies. So let's come back in here and let me go ahead and start bish bashing back and forth, and we'll get the house continued. Okay, so first things first. Oops, that's not what I wanted to do. I think that that's right. Well, I thought it was right, but apparently it's not. It's this one here, like this. Can you not do that, please? That would be epic. Excuse me, sir. Excuse me. Oh, nice! 29 damage with just a base arrow in on the demon bow. Yeah, there we go. That's good. Okay. Okay, so far so good, methinks. Alright, so we need some platforms. We're gonna need lots of platforms at some point anyway, so. Is this where? Yeah, I think this is where that goes. Something like that. So I think that this goes up. One, two, three, maybe? Like that? Does that look about right? Yeah, okay, that looks about right. And then this here should be over. Like that. And there we go. Okay. Let me go down and grab the, whatchamacallit. All the spare walls I put away. There we go, we got 200, nice. This is where it's going to get a little bit finicky. It's going to be not the most symmetrical house, but that's the point. It's meant to be kind of like a classic haunted mansion type look, where there's rooms of all different varying types in all different directions. I just built the design on a whim one day and just fell in love with it, so that's kind of how I've done it ever since. I say ever since, but, you know, 4 years ago, basically. Okay, look at all those leaves blowing off that tree, man. Okay, so the first thing that we're going to do is we're going to come back down here, and I've got my stone, and we're going to make these. We're going to make some planked walls, and we're also going to make some wooden beams. Whoa, what is this? That's new. Hat rack? That wasn't in the game before, I don't think. Interesting. Wonder if you can actually store hats on it. Alright, so we're going to change the design a little bit. So this goes, oops, that goes there. And this out here will now be changed into a normal block, like so. Okay, and that'll be sort of a support, a stilt, if you will. And the great thing about these wooden beams is you can actually put torches on them like this. But that we're not going to be doing that with this. This is mainly just for aesthetic design. And this will be our center point right here. Okay. Mr. Guide. Okay, you killed it. Oh, that tree grew. Oh, that must be where all the leaves came from when the tree grew. Okay, so the way that we're... The only way that I... Because it's hard to count how many blocks is what. Like, I know we can turn this on, right? But it's hard in a screenshot without this to count how many blocks there are. It's not like Minecraft, which is much easier to count each individual block that, you know, something's in dimensions or whatever. But here, not so much, because the textures connect so well with each other. So, if I come down, I have to guesstimate. But what I'm going to do is we're actually going to make... a bed, because that's what's going to go up there. That's basically, this area here is going to be my room, essentially. So, if we get... Where's all that cobweb? Yeah, so if we get some cobweb, and we come to the crafting bench... Actually, no, we come to the sawmill. We should be able to build a loom. And now, I'll just put the loom down. This is all temporary placement. And now we should be able to make silk. And with a certain amount of silk, I don't know how much it is. Can I already make it, actually? No. What is this? Silk rope, that's new. I don't know how much silk it takes, good lord. Oh wait, I need to be... That's why, because I need to be next to the sawmill. I'm an idiot. And in here, we should be able to... Oh, picnic tables, those are new. We should be able to make a bed. Yep, right here. Okay, it only takes 5 silk. Jeez, stupid idiot. And now, perfect. Okay, and then this. And then we'll use dirt. There should be a door here. Like this. Okay. So that's already... Okay, that's good. That's the correct dimensions that we need. Okay, so from the very second... I don't know how many blocks it is, though. Well, let me put the wall in. I'm not sleeping yet. Okay. Let me go get some more windows quick. Because the windows are going to help me, again, line everything up properly. Windows. Yeah, I'd love to make Terraria a big portion of the video content on my channel. And with mods and stuff now being officially supported, I would absolutely adore doing that. Doing different series on different mod packs and stuff, and like doing a series on expert mode and master mode and journey mode. Okay, so just off the floor here, like this, should be shaped similar to this here. Okay. And then it's only right there. I think that should be accurate. Yes, okay, that should be accurate. I'll go ahead and fill these in. Now, yes, I realize that you can see them sticking out, but that's going to be rectified momentarily. Okay, so far so good. Okay, let's come back down. We're gonna make a dresser, like so. And then we're also gonna make some more doors. That would be helpful, you know? I need a workbench for that, though. Put the dresser down right here. Put one door down on the left, or right. Put one down on the left. And then we'll do a torch here and a torch there. Bam. So that's my room. It's not done yet. I'm going to have a piggy bank right here. But we can't get a piggy bank until we get one of the NPCs to move in. Now the room's not done yet, because you might be like, well, what the fuck's this door for? Oh, you know, that's a danger to wake up to, but that, I'm going to add a little bit of an extension here, but we're going to need to go get more glass for that, because I need actual glass blocks. But that should actually be, if we use the question mark, yep, this housing is suitable. So somebody is going to end up moving in there, and I hope it's the merchant, because that's what I need. That's what I need first, at least. Okay, and by the way, we didn't put that rope in down here yet, so what we're gonna do is you can actually do this. We come down, grab the rope, we can actually do it like this, which is why rope is such a useful thing. This wasn't in Terraria originally, so you had to use platforms and stuff to actually jump up and down, and it was so tedious, it took forever. So people found other ways to use elevators without platforms. Like having water at the bottom so that they could just fall down and hit the water. Or having a grappling hook and just hoping. I just dropped my... I tried to break the torch because it was in the way, and I dropped the bloody ropes. So we're going to have to do this the old school way. Okay, there they are. And by the, it looked like, I didn't see, but somebody arrived, and I think it said the merchant, so we got exactly what what the hell is this? Hello? Oh my god, I want to capture it, but it showed me a cave. I don't have a thing to capture it with. That's new. I don't know what that is. I'd love to get it with like a net, but if it follows me up, I can actually get it by the merchant, because he sells a net. Yep, he did. Okay, so he took my room, basically. That's fine. Happiness? This is nice. Lots of privacy to store my wares. I like the scenery in the forest. A good view attracts customers. What? Does the guide have happiness? Happiness. Getting this place to myself. I greatly appreciate it. I'm quite fond of wandering through the forest. I like it here. What the hell? Okay, well, let's go to shop. Whoa! What the hell is all this shit? A sickle? Allows the collection of hay from grass. That's new to me. Forest pylon. Teleport to another pylon when two villagers are nearby. You can only place one per type in a matching biome. I no idea what that is. Never seen that before. I just want the piggy bank. And the bug net. Okay. And now, finally, if we put the piggy bank down here, I can store this money. You don't need this, especially. The piggy bank is more of like a multiplayer thing, where it's kind of like, it's similar to like an ender chest from, what's that game? Minecraft, where stuff I put into it, you and everyone else can't see if you're on the server. Only I can see it. But if they put stuff into it, only they can see it. So it's like your own personal chest that everybody can use, if that makes sense. And I think if you put in like another piggy bank down somewhere else, you can also access the stuff from that one. I don't know. I just use it because it's a piggy bank. You put money in your piggy bank. So now I have a place to actually store my money. And you can quick stack and it automatically puts the money in there in order, which is nice. So let's go ahead and set my new spawn point. I'm going to go ahead and stop here, though, and we will continue after I'm done eating. Great progress made so far. House is coming underway. See you next time.